Welcome back to Definitely Not Definitive. I am Bethany.
And I'm Ken.
And we're just a couple of spooky kids in love who love some scary movies.
Yes, we do.
And it's spooky season.
It is.
So we are going to react to the 12 spine-chilling backstories of monsters from Silent Hill.
Yeah, and so Silent Hill is a franchise we're not too familiar with, but we're going to learn a little bit more about it. This is from Marvelous Videos, and yeah, here we go.
We checked out a little bit of the game content from Silent Hill.
Yeah, some intros.
Yeah, not like the full story. We haven't played through it all, but we've checked out a little bit of that. We've not seen the movies at all. That's something we may check out maybe for this season, for spooky season. But this is bringing us more into that world.
Exactly.
Oh, the twist.
Ghastly, yeah. Monstrous creatures of the Silent Hill franchise explained. Imagine suddenly entering an alternate dimension that is carved by your deepest fears. The Silent Hill franchise portrays this exact premise while tapping into the deepest and darkest psychological fears that one can have. It has a unique approach towards horror that combines the monsters in its universe with familiar and surreal events. This makes it terrifying like nothing you've ever seen before. The monsters here are made using incredibly creepy designs that will send chills down viewers' spines while playing the game, watching the movies, or reading the comics. This video will highlight a dozen of the most nightmarish entities from the franchise. Enjoy! Before we go into our explanation, we have a very small request. Mm-hmm. If you like our content, please support us by subscribing to our channel. This is a small click for you, but for us, it means a lot. Thank you. Let's begin. God, also known as God, creator of paradise, lord of serpents, and various other names. Dark God is a mysterious sun goddess in the Silent Hill franchise. She made her debut in the first Silent Hill and has been a significant antagonistic presence. The Order, which is also known as the Organization, is a local cult situated within Silent Hill. According to the beliefs that they hold, the existence of humanity precedes that of the Dark God. This world was filled with pain and hatred. Ultimately, a man intending to seek salvation prayed to the sun, offering it a serpent, and a woman prayed, offering a reed. The world took pity on the dire states of the people, and thus God was born. After entering into the world, God brought order into it by separating it into day and night, taking away people's immortality and allowing them to die. This gave them a sense of liberation. In Silent Hill, God is a woman with orange hair, wearing red robes. She believed that she required assistance to watch over and monitor humanity. Therefore, she created several lesser gods and angels, including Lopsalvit, Jukilbara, and Valtiel. After conceiving a complete version of her world, God decided to make a place where people would be eternally satisfied. This creation required every ounce of her strength, after which she collapsed, dying, and promising to return. Dahlia Gillespie is a character who performed an unknown ritual in her house, and as a result, her daughter Alessa became pregnant with God. Due to the ritual, Alessa was severely injured, fracturing her soul, and a missing part of her manifested itself as Cheryl, a baby who landed on a highway outside Silent Hill. When Alessa and Cheryl were made whole after 7 years, God came into existence as either the incubator or incubus. In the Silent Hill universe, God is perceived as a mysterious entity and is responsible for all the horrible things that take place throughout the series.
Actions,
creations, and desires display her more like a demon or a dark goddess. She possesses a certain power over light, and her physical manifestation appears as a monster rather than a deity.
Pyramid Head.
Pyramid Head. Pyramid Head, more formally known as Red Pyramid Thing, is a humanoid monster that made his debut in Silent Hill 2. Donning a crimson helmet and dressed like a butcher, Pyramid Head was created as a manifestation of James Sunderland's guilt and desire to be punished. He exists to keep James human and remind him of his actions in the past. The weapons that he uses regularly are the Great Knife and Great Spear, instruments that represent the torment lying within James. The Silent Hill films and novels have extended Pyramid's Head role beyond a creature of vengeance and justice to being a servant of Altiel. Since Pyramid Head is meant to reflect James, he is created as an overtly masculine humanoid. In the front of his helmet lies an iron plate that he uses to attack other monsters. However, how he looks underneath the helmet is unknown to viewers and players of the game. The film rendition of Pyramid Head carries a basin with much sharper corners, while all versions of him wear an apron made of human skin with nothing covering the upper torso.
Oh.
Creepy. Altiel. First appearing in Silent Hill 3, Valtiel is an angel responsible for governing in the Order.
Does something like an angel?
His true form in Silent Hill 3, he manifested as other beings in previous installments in the franchise. The ceremonial robes that the Otherworld figures wore in Silent Hill's elementary school scene, for example, were a homage to him. Valtiel is a humanoid whose head rapidly twitches and vibrates. This makes his facial features extremely obscured, its blank, leathery texture and series of stitches horrifyingly disturbing. Behind his head is something resembling a lip and an ear. He wears the aforestated ceremonial robes, and his hands and other body parts are covered in blood. Valtiel plays a very passive role in the game. He was created by the Dark God so that he could lead people to obey her, leading to a special sect created in his honor known as the Valtiel sect. He is different from other creatures in the universe since he is not a manifestation of anyone's emotions or subconscious. He is a unique being in the other world who exists regardless of human beings, and he directly serves God. He turns the valve during several occasions, which implies that he can control one shift into the other world. Valtiel has no regard for humans, and all his actions are driven by the sole purpose of preserving the Dark God.
What the hell is that mouth there?
Abstract Daddy. Known as the ideal father, Abstract Daddy can be spotted in the most claustrophobic areas of Silent Hill. He is first encountered in Silent Hill 2 during a boss fight in the Labyrinth, an underground maze in Silent Hill. Abstract Daddy later resurfaced in the other world as a less durable enemy in the Lakeview Hotel hallways. Angela Orozco was sexually abused by her father and brother, due to which she was severely traumatized.
I can imagine.
She murdered her father by cutting his throat before trying to run away from home. However, she was overridden with guilt because of her actions and contemplated committing suicide. This damaged her psyche to the extent that she was dragged into Silent Hill, where the darkest parts of her mind manifested into nightmarish delusions and monsters that the town created. And thus, Abstract Daddy was born. Abstract Daddy is a creature that looks like two figures intertwined in a sex position and inclined over a bed frame. James is the only character who could see him in the other world, albeit in a different way than what manifested from Angela's subconscious. He perceives Abstract Daddy as resembling the memories of his wife Mary when she was bedridden. The monster's lower sphere head representing Angela and the pain she experienced over the years. Abstract Daddy attacks its victims by putting their heads into a slit in its body.
Gross.
Yeah.
All these creepy things.
Nurses. Nurses are recurring characters in the Silent Hill universe, having appeared in some form or another in all the titles. They look similar across the series and are the most prominent villains in the franchise besides Pyramid Head. Due to recurring themes of insanity, death, and hospitalization, each game takes players to either Alcamilla Hospital or Brookhaven Hospital. Once the players enter the medical facility, they encounter monsters that the townspeople have manifested in the form of the nurses. These creatures are dressed in contemporary nurses' uniforms, except for in the first rendition, where they wear cardigans. In the original Silent Hill, they are known as puppet nurses that are either blonde or brunette. They wear cardigans that are blue or green with white blouses and matching skirts. Due to Alessa Gillespie's powers, they become controlled by parasites, which made them develop a hunchback. They use scalpels to attack their victims and are very intelligent. In Silent Hill 2, the nurses are a manifestation of James Sunderland's mind due to his wife's illness, as well as him being sexually deprived. The nurses are dressed in blouses that are low-cut, displaying cleavage, their heads facing downwards and covered in gauze. Their jaws and teeth are also exposed, covered in blood. In the third installment, they look more human than their predeceasing versions. In the film, they're known as dark nurses, where they symbolize envy.
Dark.
Yeah.
Really dark.
Oh no.
Great child. Also known as Demon Child, Grey Child, or childlike monsters in Silent
Creepy
Hill,
children.
Wield knives. The Grey Children are the first characters that Harry Mason encounters in the Silent Hill game. After transitioning into the other world, he is cornered in an alley by the Grey Children, but is rescued by Sybil Bennett and taken to a diner, where he wakes up. They also regularly appear in Midwich Elementary School. A ghost form of these monsters, known as Stalkers, appears in the sewers later. The Grey Children do not appear in the European or Japanese version of the Silent Hill game. They're only exclusive to the North American version. Instead, they are replaced by creatures called mumblers because the censor board thought they looked too similar to real children. The Grey Children look like child creatures that have pale grayish-green skin. They hold long knives and have mouths that look like large gaps. Instead of eyes, they have a series of incisions on their faces. However, in the film, they have eyes that stare, and their faces are twisted on their head's side.
That's pretty terrifying.
Burn from the inside out and scream like a child who is in agonizing pain. They usually attack their victims in groups of three and leap at them as they approach their target. The Grey Children are Alessa Gillespie's classmates who bullied her when she was in school. This caused her extreme emotional turmoil. After she was burned alive, she dragged her classmates into the other world, where they were turned into monsters and tortured with the same pain that she underwent constantly.
If they
were alive in the real world, the Grey Children would be 40-year-old adults, but they are condemned to be children forever.
Well, you gotta be D-bag.
What the F?
Needler. The Needler appears in Silent Hill Homecoming and is encountered by Alex Shepard in the Grand Hotel elevator. He is attacked by five of them as they break through the walls of the elevator. The Needler is a humanoid monstrosity with a masculine torso and sharp blades in the place of limbs. These blades are the mode of movement and weapon of attack. And Needler looks like its head has been removed and a sharp mod mouth that is located between its legs. There are two holes situated on either side of its chest that slowly open and close. Needlers spontaneously appear in various parts of the game by treading on the ground or climbing out of pipes or random holes. They move very fast, being one of the few monsters in the Silent Hill universe that can dodge a player's attacks if targeted from the front. Their severed head-like appearance is a possible foreshadowing of Joshua Shepard's death, who dies by breaking his neck. The Needler may be a representation of the truth that continuously nags in Alex's subconscious.
What the F?
Twin victims. Also known as the Doublehead, the twin victims made their debut in Silent Hill 4, The Room, but have also appeared in the Dead/Alive comic. The twin victims, as their name suggests, looks like a set of conjoined twin babies dressed in a dirty, tattered scarf. They have pale skin and disproportionately enormous arms. They use these appendages to stand and move around, not attacking unless provoked and behaving indifferently. Their limbs can extend to a surprisingly large distance and can cause
damage if they hit someone.
When they fall after an attack, they begin sobbing and throwing a tantrum like children often do. To fight the twin victims, one might need to use steel pipes, aluminum bats, or rusty axes.
Asphyxia.
Asphyxia is an obscure being resembling a hideous beast. She is a manifestation of Margaret Holloway, filled with vengeance due to her daughter Nora's memories. Asphyxia looks like a stack of gruesome woman corpses fused together, combined with a centipede, 16 hands, a pair of legs with no feet, and a deformed face with missing eyes. When Alex Shepard finds Margaret Holloway strapped to a chair, he quickly frees her from it, and Asphyxia appears. Alex takes Margaret to safety before Asphyxia drags him into a hole in the wall. He seals the door, trapping both of them in the hole. Despite this, Alex manages to prevail. Although she has several limbs that she can attack with, she primarily uses her four main arms. One of her techniques is to spin around and knock her victim down with her tail section. Moreover, she charges her victims head-on or shrieks loudly to overwhelm the prey. However, she contains one weakness. She is relatively easy to deflect or dodge, and her tail section is a weak area of her body. Alex struck this part of her body hard. Damaged, he put his hand over her mouth, making it difficult for her to breathe, and killed her. The reason for the large number of limbs that Asphyxia has is the method in which Nora Holloway was sacrificed by her mother to appease the Dark God. Despite her ghastly appearance, it is evident that Asphyxia's body is highly sexualized. She leads a tormented existence, and a green substance emerges from her tail whenever she swipes at someone. Scarlet, Silent Hill, Homecoming. Scarlet is a manifestation
like a kneeler,
of
almost.
Martin Fitch's guilt over murdering his daughter. She is also the second boss monster in Silent Hill Homecoming.
Okay,
Fitch murdered his daughter by dismembering her as a sacrifice to honor a pact that he made with the Order and the Dark God. Due to his wishes of being reunited with her, she might even be a twisted reincarnation of his daughter. She contains higher emotional intelligence than the rest of the monsters in the series.
Killing her dad.
The only boss monster whose name is the same as the deceased, which she represents.
Yeah.
She first appeared when Alex Shepard found Dr. Fitch in Hell's Descent, which is the fractured representation of his mental state in the other world. When he is presented with one of his daughter's dolls, it says Daddy, instantly opening wounds and filling the room with a pool of his blood.
Ooh.
He drops the doll, which transforms into the monster. Fitch begs for forgiveness
for what
he did to Scarlet when she was alive. Although the monster seems to consider the plea, she ultimately bites Fitch's head off and flings his body aside. However, Scarlet is killed by Alex, who stabs her with a crowbar. Scarlet resembles a monstrous, lanky, doll-like figure whose body is constructed from white armor, which has been divided into segments. She looks like a broken porcelain doll containing a flesh underlining. Likewise, her head is hollow and can be easily shattered. She has needle-like teeth in her mouth and hisses and shrieks like a snake. In order to hurt Scarlet, one must destroy her outer shell. After being defeated once, she enters into another phase where she crawls on all fours like a spider and moves much quicker.
Stay where you are! Stop!
Don't think he cares about your rules. Oh!
Lying Figure, Silent Hill 2. The Lying Figure is a humanoid behemoth that lurks in Silent Hill 2. This is the first creature encountered by James Sunderland after following the trail of blood through Silent Hill. There he finds it feeding on a corpse in a closed tunnel. A rendition of the Lying Figure is seen in the film and is called the Armless Man. Its entire body is trapped in something that resembles a straitjacket made of flesh. It has stereotypically feminine legs, and its buttocks is visible to everyone. It wears a pair of platform heels on its feet covered in flesh. Their method of movement includes scurrying across the ground while making a high-pitched noise. The Lying Figure's attack method involves involves the splatting of a poisonous mist from an opening in their chest. This forces their victims to back off while they take time to recover. The best way to deal with them is from a distance with a handgun. When they stand up, their movement speed reduces. The lying figure represents a patient at a hospital who is squirming due to undergoing immense pain. It is a manifestation of James's internal suffering as well as feelings of confinement. Insane Cancer. Insane Cancer first appeared in Silent Hill 3 and is an obese, monstrous humanoid possessing extreme Hulk-like strength. Heather Mason first encountered them after she picked up a shotgun in an abandoned train. The creatures receive their name from their physical appearance that Hulk resembles a cancerous mass. They are covered in fatty flesh with pus-like substances pouring out of open sores. Their heads are like small bulbs with an opening that looks a bit like a wound. Their attacking strategy involves throwing their fat arms with sharp claws towards their victims. It's best to avoid the insane cancer and find a safe place to hide. However, considering their size, this is often difficult. The insane cancer is representative of the corruption in Silent Hill. Moreover, they reflect several other things like Alessa Gillespie's feelings that continue to reemerge. It also could be a manifestation of the fetal god that lies inside Heather. Elements of body horror in relation to sci-fi pregnancies. And if you liked our content, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to us if you haven't already. Have a good one and be safe. Thanks, everyone.
Oh, going through her.
What in the actual...
Well, that was disturbing.
Yeah, you could say that about most of the things that we saw.
Yeah.
Silent Hill is effectively disturbing and very creative with their monster designs. And I like the premise that, like, basically they are manifestations of people's, like, fears and nightmares.
Yeah, I often, when I like scary stuff, will like the psychological thrillers, because those are the ones that tend to, I think, stay with me the longest. With this, it seems like there is a larger story that is... really, like, what is our brain capable of in our worst psychological moments, and how could that possibly manifest in the real world? And that's a fascinating premise, deeply disturbing, but it definitely makes me want to see this film series and possibly play this game at some point.
I can see why Pyramid Head is, like, the most famous character from this game. A very great design and character that definitely sticks with you. Terrifying, even in the movies, what I saw. But I think, like, the doctor, like, sacrificing his kid and then having that manifest, and, like and the kid, like, he drops a doll and it turns into to the monster, and then it ends up eating him. That one really stuck with me. That and the woman who had gotten raped by, like, her brother and
the
her
hypersexualized
dad.
One.
Yeah.
Like, the female torsos.
Oh, yeah, yeah, that one. But then, like, the one that, like, where she got raped by, like, her dad and her brother, and then, like, it was, like, daddy cart or whatever, like the...
Oh, yeah, yeah, the one that looked like a penis.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So that one was also very messed up.
Yeah.
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 Any stand out as being more disturbing to you as than others? Or more just, like, memorable?
I think the nurse is particularly disturbing in the sense that, like, this guy's wife was dying. We get the sense that that was horrific to him. It's not like he was estranged from his wife or didn't care. It sounds like he did very much, but also, like, he was dealing with his own, I think, lack of fulfillment in various needs. I'm sure, like, the sexual side of it is just one piece. There's obviously a lot more that I'm sure he's experiencing. But the personification of that in the nurses, this kind of, like, low-cut, cleavage-bearing little nurse uniform on these creatures that are faceless, that have, like, this gross mouth, that are kind of... I think that stuck out to me the most, just because I'm like, I track that as attainable in our world, I think, a little bit more than something like Pyramid Head or, like, the multi-stacked female torso. Like there's something about there I was like... I thankfully have never been in that situation, but, like, I understand what what they were playing with here and the concept here. And yeah, that I'm sure that probably happens, which is no knock against the spouse that's healthy, but watching your spouse suffer and deal with a terminal illness and not being able to connect with them physically and probably not even fully emotionally because you're, I have to imagine, a wreck, but you're trying to be strong for them. Like, that's certainly going to mess with you. And yeah, I think that that made the nurse stick out in that way.
Yeah, I would agree. Let us know some more good Silent Hill videos to check out. And like I said, like Bethany said, we're probably going to play the games and check out the movies. I don't know which order we're gonna do them in. I know the games count first. The movies are based on the games. And the movies aren't maybe like not necessarily the best. And the games, like, you know, obviously the best way to experience the story and whatnot. But I mean, they are older now. I think they came out with a more recent one, though. Silent Hill. We checked out the trailers for that a little while ago. I think last year or something like that. Anyways, give us some more suggestions down below in the comments. And thanks so much for checking out our reaction for 12 spine-chilling backstories of Silent Hill. But just keep in mind
that our reaction is definitely not definitive.